In my last video, I shared with you how to install managed WordPress hosting on Flywheel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how easy it is to install your WordPress theme on your newly installed WordPress website. Are you ready to get started? Then let's go. Before we get started, let me answer a quick question that I get quite often, and that is, what is a WordPress theme? A WordPress theme is the software that you install on your WordPress website that gives your website its overall design. And there are lots of different themes to choose from. There are both free and premium paid versions of themes. There are literally thousands and thousands of different themes. And it's no wonder that many, many of you get so frustrated and look to turn to the internet for help. It is a cause of lots of frustration with lots of people that I talk to. So you are not alone. And in today's video, I want to make it super easy for you to get your WordPress theme installed so that you can get on your way with building your website. Here we are, all logged into my WordPress demo site. Now, this is the behind the scenes dashboard where you will customize your website. But first, I want to take you back out to the front to show you what it looks like. And we'll just click the little toggle on the left-hand side. And here we go. So WordPress comes installed with a standard WordPress theme. And you'll see here that it's really kind of boring and not that exciting. So let me take you back over to the dashboard. And I'm going to show you where you'll go to install your WordPress theme. So you'll scroll down to Appearance and click on Themes. Now, if you click on the Add New button, you will be able to see a lot of different WordPress themes that you can choose from right inside your dashboard. Where I see a lot of you get stuck is that you just don't know what theme to choose. And so you'll end up choosing a lot of different themes, trying to get one that fits your needs. However, what I found after trying lots and lots of different themes, that there is one or two themes that I keep coming back to time and time again, because they're able to be customized so many different ways that it makes it so easy to get the look that you're going for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what that theme is and how to get installed today. My favorite WordPress theme is Astra, and it's available both as a free or paid theme. So in order to find it, we can go ahead and type in Astra in the search bar, and it will pop up here. Now I'm going to go ahead and install it. Now you'll notice by the preview that it doesn't look that much more amazing than the 2020 theme. However, what you can do with it after is what makes it so amazing. So we're going to go ahead and click activate. I also, in another video, shared with you another one of my favorite themes, GeneratePress. Now, both themes are pretty similar in that they're both really fast. They have, they're well-coded. They have great support. So that way, they're very similar. More and more, I've been going back to Astra because they just seem to work really well with my favorite page builder, Beaver Builder, and are just really easy to customize. Now, another step that I like to do is I like to add a child theme to my new projects. So what I'll do is for Astra, it's super easy to create and add a child theme. What you'll do is I'll leave a link below to the WordPress Astra website where you can create your own child theme. Go ahead and give your child theme a name. I'm just going to call it Astra Child. There are some advanced options if you want to fill this out. I am not going to do that at this time. I'm just going to go ahead and generate. And you'll go ahead and save as. You go back to Appearance Themes in your dashboard, and we'll click on Add New. Now this time, instead of searching, since we already have Astra installed, we're going to go ahead and click Upload Theme. Down here in my downloads bar on my Mac is the file. So I'm just going to go ahead and drag that up to the file, drop it in, and click Install Now. And our theme has been installed successfully. So I'll go ahead and click Activate. Now you'll see here that I have both the Astra Child theme as well as the Astra theme installed. This looks great. Now, I want to take you back out to the
front end of the website so you can see the difference. Now, here is our just generic Astra theme installed. It doesn't look that much more exciting. In fact, it looks horrible right now. So what you can do is once you have your theme installed, you can go ahead and click customize in the top navigation bar to begin customizing. But before I do that, I like to go back to the dashboard, and I'll show you another trick that makes it super simple to get your WordPress a starting point to begin editing from. So this is a little trick that I love, and we're going to go down to appearance and then down to Astra options. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see import starter site. Now, what a starter site is it gives you a starting point for your website. It actually installs a pre-designed website that you can use as a starting point to begin your design. The reason why I love this is it saves so much design time, and you're going to go ahead and get a website with a design already installed in just a few clicks. So what we'll do is I'll go ahead and click on Install Importer Plugin. One thing to note while this is installing is that there is a pro version of Astra and there is a pro version of the starter site. It comes with the Astra pro version. So if you like more options, definitely check that out. And I'll leave a link to those below so you can see what additional options you can get with those. The first thing you're going to do once you have the starter sites installed is you're going to select a page builder. Now, if you're not familiar with page builders, what they do is they're a plugin that allows you to easily build out your pages with the drag and drop functionality. Now, Gutenberg is what's installed with your website with WordPress, so that comes standard. Elementor is similar to Beaver Builder and then also Busy. Now, my favorite two are Elementor and Beaver Builder. So, for this example, I'm going to go ahead and choose Beaver Builder and click on Next. And on the next screen, you're going to see over 100 plus websites that are already built and designed professionally. All you have to do is select one and then click install. And you can go ahead and scroll through. There's quite a wide variety here to look at. There's blog, business, e-commerce. Now, what you'll notice is some of them have like a little box that say agency. So what that means is those are only available with the paid version of starter sites. So if you do like one of those, reach out to me or you can follow the link below to go ahead and purchase that on your own. Well, let's start by clicking on this nutritionist site. So I really like the colors of this site and they do a good job of the design. And the layout looks really good. And then she has the book. Yeah, so I really like this one and it's gonna give us a great starting point. Now the key here is even if you're not a nutritionist and you love the layout of this website, you can still choose it. Once you have this site imported, you will be able to customize the logo colors and everything and photos and images to reflect your brand and your design. So what I love is it just gives me a starting point with everything pre-installed, and then I can customize from there. So don't get too hung up on the fact that this is for a nutritionist. I could just as easily use this website as a starting point for many other different projects. So I like this. Over on the left-hand side, I'm going to click all the check marks. I want to delete any previously imported site, and it's done. So once you get the done notification, you can go ahead and click on view site and we'll see what it looks like. All right, this looks really good. So you'll see that in just a few minutes, we were able to install an entire website pre-designed for us all in just a few minutes. This looks really good. We can go ahead and customize our website further now that we've got it installed. So to do that, there's a couple different ways that you can do this. Now to get started, I always like to start with customize. Up in the left-hand corner, there's a little paintbrush and you can go ahead and click on customize in order to set your logo, your colors, and a few other things before you get started. Okay, So you'll see here that there's a link for your global options, which includes your fonts, your colors, the container size, and your buttons. So that will customize the entire website. We can go in a little bit deeper here. And for site identity, you will upload your logo and a site icon. The site icon is just up here where that little world globe is. You'll replace that in the browser. And for sure, we want to replace our site title and our tagline. We don't want it to say just another WordPress site. So once you get that done, you can go back. There's a primary header. You can customize how your header looks as well as on your mobile. The primary menu, you can customize how that looks. And a transparent header. So if you want your header to be transparent, you can customize that as well. And again, if you're looking for a lot more options for customization, you'll want to go check out the Astra Pro version. So again, I'll link to that in the description below so you can see all the additional options that are available for you with that version. Now, if we go back, I want to show you how you're going to edit each individual page. Now, if you remember, before we installed this starter site, I chose Beaver Builder as my page builder. Now, in this example, I'm going to show you how to edit your page with Beaver Builder. So at the top, I'm going to click on Beaver Builder. And this will open up my page builder editor, where I can go ahead and start swapping out the images and the text. Now, it looks like this might be our first time, so if you want to take a tour, it will show you around. However, I'm just going to go ahead and get started and show you a few things about how to edit. What you'll do is if you hover over any of these modules, they will allow you to swap out. So here is the image. What I would do is I would swap out this image then. The image recommendation is 564 by 700 pixels. I can go ahead and edit to replace that image with my own. And then there's a lot more customizations you can do. For example, here we are on the text. And this is just a heading text, and you can customize this exactly how you want. And then click save. When you're done making your changes, up in the top right hand corner, you'll click on done and publish. Another trick I want to share with you is that when you're editing, I like to, once I'm done making all my changes, and I like to go in and click on responsive editing. This will give us an option to see how things look on both like a tablet and mobile. And we want to make sure that our website looks good on both of these as well as on desktop. So this is the tablet version, and that looks pretty good. The thing is, when we go to mobile version, we want to make sure things are still looking good there. So we can scroll down. Now, some things I see here are like there's some extra spaces. If you would want to get rid of that, you would just click on it, and we would edit this. It happens to be a column. So now you'll see here where there's a little mobile view. We can turn this off for mobile. So you'll see that right here by the mobile image. And so down to visibility, we can put on display. We would just put this to large and medium devices only. Click save, and that will remove it from our mobile view. So you can see that there. Everything else is looking pretty good. Again, here, you may want to remove those extra spaces. But yeah, that looks pretty good on mobile. Once you're done, again, we can click exit. It'll go back to desktop view and hit done and publish, and that will save our changes. That's it. I hope you found this video useful to install a WordPress theme on your brand new WordPress website. And in today's video, we took it one step further, where I showed you how to install a starter site to give you a head start on your overall design. Hey guys, my name is Jennifer Franklin, and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. Each week, I'll bring you a brand new video, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and leave me a comment below. See you later.